Good afternoon. Today is a wonderful day that God has blessed us all to see. And I was talking with a friend of mine the other day about that we need to try to forgive one another more often. We need to try to help one another more often, to love one another, encourage each other. But you know, I tell people all the time that sometimes we have to encourage one another. And the thing about that is that, you know, and in this lesson, I guess if I was to title this lesson, it would be forgiveness. But then getting into the lesson and things, and just getting into the lesson right now, and just in the book of Genesis, it says in the book of Genesis 8, in Genesis 18:23-26, it said, Abraham said, wilt thou also destroy the righteous with the wicked? Peradventure, there would be 50 within the city. Wilt thou also destroy, not spare the place for the 50 righteous that are within? Shall not the judge of all earth do right? And the Lord said, if I find in Sodom 50 righteous within the city, then I will spare all the place for them. Now, saying all of that and doing all of this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go all the way back and I'm going to read from my King James Bible. You know, because I stumbled all across that. And that's something that I don't do. We never supposed to stumble over the Word of God, because that's what we have. And when I stumble and do things like that, I like to go back and I like to read it.
Amen.
So y'all excuse me. In Genesis 18:23-26, he says, and Abraham came near and said, would you also destroy the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there were 50 righteous within the city. Would you also destroy the place and not spare it for 50 righteous that were in it? Far be it from you to do such a thing at this, to slay the righteous with the wicked, so that the righteous should be as the wicked. Far be it from you, shall not judge all the earth. All the earth do right. Now, the reason why Abraham didn't really want him to destroy the city of Sodom was because his nephew Lot was there, and Lot was family. You know, and in that situation, if God was to come to us right now today, if God was to come to us and as he came with the two angels and he spoke to you, and if that situation came about where he was going to destroy a place where your mother or your father or your brother or even your nephew was there, or a family member, would you ask them to forgive? Would you ask God to forgive them and save just that one person? Mm. Would you ask him? Would you ask him to forgive? You know, but then we serve a forgiving God. We serve a God. Amen. We serve a merciful
yes.
God.
Hallelujah.
And I believe in my heart, you know. But then the Bible says that Abraham was a friend to God. He was a friend of God. So the thing about it is, if he came to you and he was talking about destroying a place, and a person wronged you, just say a person wronged you and you knew the Lord was going to destroy, would you ask the Lord to forgive them? Mm. Would you ask the Lord to forgive you and to spare their lives? Mm. Would you ask? That's the question. Because in this world today, we simply just don't forgive. But then the Lord said that you must forgive men of their trespasses, or he won't forgive you of your trespasses. So we must forgive. And even in the scripture, it always talks about different things. And even in Psalms 51:1-2, it says, have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sins. I ask God, do you pray like that? Do you ask God to forgive you? Do you ask God to this? You know, I'm talking about that, because everybody, the Word of God talks about all have sinned and have fallen short of God's glory. Do you ask God to forgive you? You know, do you ask Him? You know, I walk around a lot of times during the day, and people say things to me that I don't like. You know, people even try things that they have no business trying. But the question is, would you forgive them? Do you have enough forgiveness in your heart to just forgive? Do you? You know, and see, and that's something that we all struggle with because, you know, back in the day or even right now, if somebody might say something to you out of the way and you be walking around like, I'll get you back. And there's a lot of us, and it's a lot of Christian folks do the same thing today. It ain't just the people in the world, it's the folks that's in the church is doing the same thing. I'll get them, and they don't have no forgiveness.
Amen.
You know, I've sat around people and they talk about other folks and talk about their business. Yeah, he said this and he said that. Just forgive. You know what I'm saying? Just forgive. You know, because we all want God to forgive us. But would you classify it wrong for God not to forgive you if you don't forgive anybody else? That's what I'm saying. And see, and that is a situation. And even in Matthew chapter 6 and 12, he said, forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. What do you think? What do you think about that scripture? I'm going to read it again. He said, forgive us our debts. Lord, forgive us our debts. You know, as we forgive our debtors. You know, even in when we have bill collectors, we go out and make bills and do all we can and try to and have this and have that. But we get mad when the light man come. Or he wants to come and cut off our lights. He want to come take our vehicle. He wants to put us out of our home. You know what I'm saying? But those are things. You know, those are just things. Do you have enough forgiveness? Your brother might say something to you. You might owe somebody some money, you know? You know, and it says again, it says, forgive us our debtors. I forgive them. I'm talking about, man, the bill collectors come, I forgive them. You know, even if I have to pay a portion of something or we have to move something around to do something, I forgive.
Amen.
Because the Lord said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. That's what he said. That's my hope. So do we forgive? And there's a lot of things. There's a lot of things that people don't understand. You know, and then in the book of Luke 23 and 34, he said, Then said Jesus, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Man, do you know how many times people wrong people every day? You got people that's dying out there. And they Christian folks. Look at ISIS. You got ISIS out here beheading children. You got ISIS out here, they killing reporters. They doing all kinds of things. But when the time come for you, when your time come, if you're ever on your knees with a sack over your head and your hand tied behind your back, could you say, Lord, forgive them, for they know not what they do? Do you have enough forgiveness in your heart to forgive? Do you have it? And then if we go into Matthew 18 and 21 through 22, then came Peter to him and said, Lord, how oft shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him till seven times? Jesus said unto him, I say not unto thee, until seven times, but I, until seven times seven. If your brother keep coming to you, basically what he's saying is, you know, Lord, how often should I forgive my brother? And Jesus basically saying, you know, seven, and he said seven times. Jesus said, no, seven times 70. 70 times seven. We don't even have it once in our life. Sometimes we don't forgive like that. Because I remember back in the day when I was coming along, man, I used to have, by me being a man of God, back in the day, man, I used to have grudges. I used to have a lot of unforgiveness in my heart. I'm talking about it for people that do anything to me. I didn't care who they was. If they were family members, man, if they was my partners, they was running, that I was running with, or even somebody I knew, you know what I'm saying? Or even they didn't even have to know I had that unforgiveness in me. But the only thing, I said, thank God for Jesus, because when you offend me right off the bat, I'm going to forgive you right there. And I told a brother today, I said, if I have offended you, because there was a situation happened, and I had to stop, and I told him, I said to him, I said, brother, if I have offended you, please forgive me. Yeah. And he paused for a minute. Yeah. Do you have enough strength to forgive people? Do you have enough of Jesus in your heart to where you have forgiveness? Do you have it in you? You know, and see, that's the thing about it. And that's, but then when we go on into the book of Acts 3:19, he said, repent ye therefore and be converted, and your sins may be blotted out, when the time of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Repent. Repent. God is faithful. The Lord is faithful. Lord, forgive me for my sins. Lord, forgive me. He is faithful. He will forgive you. We serve an awesome, we serve a merciful, forgiving. We serve a most gracious and loyal and loving man. God is everything. But then the question is, do you have enough forgiveness in your heart if it came down to forgiving somebody for what they did against you? Because a lot of times we always complain about what they did to us. But then a lot of times we don't ever say nothing about what we did. So, do you have enough forgiveness? Do you have enough forgiveness? And in Psalms 51:1-2, it says, have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies. Blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sins. I think I read that a few minutes ago. And that scripture just stays with me. Because, boy, I tell you, a long time ago, boy, I need God's mercy in my life. I need God's forgiveness in my life, because without it, I can't do it. I don't know how to do it.
Amen.
I know that I practice. See, a lot of people don't know that when you walk in forgiveness. Because if you can walk in unforgiveness, you can walk in forgiveness. And it's a walk. Sometimes you might have to, you had to ask God to help you. You had to ask the Lord, Father God, help me do this. Lord Jesus called, he said, whosoever call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ shall be saved. I can't do this by myself. Lord, I need your help. I have done it. I have said, Lord, I just can't do it. And I prayed for the Lord. I had a situation where I was dealing with unforgiveness, and you know, sometimes we have something in our heart that sometimes that God will take you back and he'll show it to you, and it'd be so real light the way you barely could see it, to where you barely get there, you barely even know it. And one night I said, Lord, help me, Lord. I said, Lord, if I have anything in my heart against anybody in my family, any of my loved ones, any of my friends, or whoever that is, what? I said, Lord, I can't do this without you, Lord. I said, help me. Heal me, Lord. Get this unforgiveness out of me, Lord, because I know that if I got unforgiveness in me, I won't never see you. But if I see you, it'll be going into another direction. It won't be with you for the rest of my life. So, Lord, I need these things. I need to get my life. I need to get this unforgiveness out of my life in order for me to be saved. And the Lord started working with me. He started saying things to me. I start praying more. I start talking to the Lord more. I start telling him about saying different things to the Lord about different things. And the Holy Spirit started talking to me. And the Lord started speaking to me. You know, and early in the morning, and sometimes I'll be to myself and be quiet. He'll say certain things to me. You know what I'm saying? And he said it again. And I said to you again. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Do you have enough Jesus in you? Sometimes we get ashamed when we call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. But he said, but if you ashamed of me before men, man, I'll be ashamed of you before my Father in heaven. So, or do you have enough for, do you have enough in you to call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and ask him to help you with that unforgiveness in your heart? Do you have enough? Do you have enough in you? And in Isaiah 55 and 7, he said, let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. You know, sometimes we walk around, you know, and I know that some young ladies do it, and some that say they don't. Some guys say they don't do it, but most of them do. You might walk out there, you might admire some young lady, or you might walk out there, you admire some man. Sometimes we have thoughts going on. Sometimes we have them thoughts going on. Do you immediately say, Lord, forgive me for that thought? Because it happens to everybody. And if you're sad that it don't happen to you, that means you ain't lying to me, you lying to yourself and you lying to God.
Amen.
You know, now if you got them thoughts, now if you got some thoughts about your wife now, then you on the right track, you know. Or your husband, you on the right track. But when we out there in the street, they always talk about if a man look upon a woman in lust, women do the same thing. You know, we all, women and men do it. But do you have enough forgiveness in your heart? They say, Lord, I didn't mean to look at that. Lord, and then sometimes our minds wonder sometimes. Do you have enough in you to say, Lord, forgive me? I said, I had no business looking at that. Lord, I should have said that to that person. Lord, you know, forgive me, Lord. Or do you have enough when you and a person have had words or, you know, about nothing, you know? There's nothing in this world that's worth not showing love to anybody. If you had a person that you might, a brother or sister, maybe a relative, maybe a good friend or somebody, or maybe somebody on the job, and some words was said, are you the bigger person? Would you go to him and say, would you please forgive me? If I have offended you, please forgive me. You know, and I like to apologize. You know, I do it, and I would do it in a heartbeat, because I don't ever want anybody to be feeling any way about me, and I don't want to feel any way about anybody except love. Do you have enough forgiveness in your heart? You know what I'm saying? Because when you got that forgiveness in your heart and you got the forgiveness of Jesus Christ, you have the courage. You have the courage to walk up and say, excuse me, can I speak to you for, hey, can I talk to you for, look, I apologize. It don't matter who's standing around you. You know, the Lord said forgive. He didn't say, you know, well, do this, or he didn't say go around and write a letter. He said, go to him, talk to him. Forgive people. If you forgive people their trespasses, God will forgive you your trespasses. Nobody is exempt from this. You must forgive. But it's a thing that and in Psalms 30, 130, 3 through 4, and it says that if thou, Lord, shouldest mark iniquities, O Lord, how shall I stand? But there is unforgiveness with thee, that thou may eat. Be feared. You know, in that situation, do you have unforgiveness? And whatever situation you're going in life, whatever direction, you know, the Bible talks about the narrow path. When you're walking on that narrow path, you got to have forgiveness. You got to have love. You got to have mercy. You know what I'm saying? As we go before the throne of grace, as we talk to the Lord, you got to have forgiveness. Do you have forgiveness in your life? And even in that saying in 1 John 4 and 10, he said, herein is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the perpetuation for our sins. You know, one thing about it, Jesus forgave us of our sins. Jesus forgave us of our sins. That's what I feel like what it means. Jesus forgave us of our sins. And it would be a really bad thing. It would be a really bad thing if you didn't forgive people their trespasses or didn't forgive people their sins and just forgive people. And you didn't have enough forgiveness in you to forgive people. You know, we've all done wrong. We've all sinned. We've all did all kind of things. Some of us have murdered and killed and did everything. But you know, for forgiveness, the Lord has forgiveness for a man that's a woman that's a homosexual, and they stop in their path and they turn and they go toward the Lord and stop what they're doing. Jesus has forgiveness. Even for those people that have murdered or did things and it's touched their heart. People have been known to be saved through stuff like that. You know, even in crimes, even in life, even when you mistreat people. Jesus laid it down. He laid it down. I'm talking about. So the question is, can you lay it down? Can you forgive? Because it's a really dangerous thing. If you can forgive people their trespasses, Jesus will forgive you your trespasses. Mm-hmm. But remember, he says that in the book of John, no one comes to the Father except through me. So just imagine when you're going on and everything coming along and then you have to go before the Lord. But then that might be the only thing that you got. He said, you didn't forgive so-and-so. When you see him, it's too late. It's too late. Some people think that they're going to be able to talk to Jesus when it ain't going to be like that. We have free will. But what if that forgiveness will be the only thing that will keep you out of heaven? That's the only thing. You done passed the test. You done ran the race. You done did everything you had to do. But you had just a little slight of unforgiveness in your heart. You know. But see, now, I read it in the King James Version. I read it in the King James Version. But I'm going to read it. I want to read it again. And I feel like I need to read it again. I'm going to read it again in the New King James Version. I'm going to read it in the New King James Version. And it says, in this love, and not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his son to be the perpetuation for our sins. But I'm going to go ahead on to verse 11 when it said, beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. God loved us so much. You know, he loved us so much, even from Adam and Eve to where, even when he said to be fruitful and multiply, and the world standing from creation and all the way up to Noah, to where he destroyed the earth by water. And then from Noah and his three sons and his three wives and their three wives and everybody from there. And he also said that he would never destroy the world anymore by water. Never be a flood again. But it's going to be by fire this time. And that's what I believe. So the thing about it is, even from way back when he started creating everybody, the catch is, would you forgive? Because Jesus Christ forgave you, and it was before you was even born. Would you forgive? Do you have enough strength in you to forgive? Do you have enough in you to forgive? You know, and it's a powerful thing, but I'm gonna have to go, which I want you to go with me to the book of Mark. I want you to go with me to the book of Mark, and it's 11 and 25. And that's a lot of things that go on, a lot of people don't know. But we got to tell somebody. And it says that, and whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, forgive him, that your Father in heaven may also forgive you your trespasses. My Lord. But if we're going on to 26, he said, but if you do not forgive, neither will your Father in heaven forgive your trespasses. So today, do you have enough courage? Do you have enough courage to forgive people their trespasses against you? Do you have enough? You know, because people, we say things sometimes. And sometimes we wear our feelings on our sleeves and on our shirts a lot of times. Mm-hmm. Where we just, if people say little bitty things and they go to joking around and you get your feelings hurt and that thing, you know, unforgiveness is set up in your heart and you're thinking in your mind how you're going to get them, whether it's good or bad or whether it be funny or whatever. You know. But then he said, whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, forgive him that your Father in heaven may also forgive your trespasses. But if you do not forgive, neither will your Father in heaven forgive your trespasses. I do everything in my power to forgive. I do everything in my power to forgive, you know, and I do everything in my power to forgive. And I had to ask the Lord to help me. And even in the book of Luke 7:48-50, and he said unto her, thy sins are forgiven, and that thou hast set at meat with him, began to say within themselves, who is that forgiveth sins also? And he said to the woman, thy faith hath saved thee. Go in peace. You know, even for the woman that was caught in adulterous affair, she was forgiven. The Lord forgave her, and he also will forgive you.
Amen.
That means you need to forgive. Even when Jesus was sitting with the religious leaders and they was talking about and they were talking about the woman, that she's not supposed to be there with them, you know, in a certain setting, and they was talking about she was defiling them and stuff like that, but Jesus he forgave her of her sins. Today Jesus will forgive you of your sins right now. And as I close right now, would you bow your head and pray with me in the name of Jesus? Father God, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for your wonderful grace and mercy in our lives and your faithfulness and just forgiving us of our sins. Father God, Father God, we ask you, Father God, to forgive us our sins and our trespasses against you, Father God, and the Lord Jesus Christ, and against everybody. Lord, Lord, I thank you for blessing my life. And I thank you, Lord, for blessing and strengthening me, Lord, to where I'm able to go and do the things I need to do, Lord. And give me the strength, Lord, to where I'm able to encourage. Well, if a person come to me that's in unforgiveness, and I can encourage them, and I can show them, I can say, hey, look, and I can show them what your word says. Lord, I thank you. I thank you for this Bible study. Lord, I thank you for everything that you're doing in my life, Lord. Lord, I thank you for what you're going to do. I thank you for salvation and free ministry, the ministry that you've given me and the race that I'm running. I thank you for my children and my family. You know, I even thank you for the lady that's in my life, that woman that's in my life. That woman, I even thank you for her. I even just thank you for my life. I am so grateful, you know, Lord. I thank you for forgiving me of my sins, because, boy, I used to be rough at one time. But, you know, but then I continue to pray, Lord, and thank you for your wonderful grace and mercy in my life. And these things I pray in the wonderful, mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen.